guys. Today I'm here with some DIY brain boosting activities. Generally I do it on a book so that we maintain everything on the record, but now the book is exhausted, and since I am unable to go out, I found some of the white sheets and I have done each one on them. So first one, you can see this is circle the sequence, and I have given some sequences here. Some 5 sequences are here. Against that I have put the dot markers. What the child has to do is he'll have to find the sequence. This one, where is this? Here. And look for the blue sketch pen and then circle it. Similarly, he's going to complete for the rest of the sequences like this. And next one, again I have this doodle dot, and since I have this dot markers from long time and we haven't been really using it, here are the dot markers and the colors are put here. These are the bigger digit number. If for the little child, you can use the single digit like 1 to 10 or however you think is applicable to your child finds it easy. So I asked Rithvik to randomly say some 3 digit number, and these numbers were said by him. I have put these numbers here and then given a color code for each number. The child has to find the number here, and wherever it is 515, he'll have to take the pink dot marker and then stamp it. Wherever 515 here and here. Similarly, he is going to complete the rest of the sheet here. This is so all of us in our childhood, we would have definitely played this game. This is a dot and dash is what we used to call. So how most of you know how this can be played, and I'm introducing this to my son. This game starts with an empty grid of dots. Two players taking turns adding a single horizontal or vertical line between two unjoined adjacent dots, and then a player who completes the fourth side is going to be is going to earn 1 point. Like that, we keep on doing this one. So no need to explain about this game. Everybody knows. It's just that I'm introducing to my son now. Next one, we have this replicate the pattern. And yeah, I have to say something here. We all know, whoever's following my channel, I'm sure you guys also know Sonali from It Starts at Home. So basically I've kept telling her that I'm going to copy this idea, but I've never done that so far. So this time she is the queen of brain boosting DIY activities. So here I have taken this this activity from her. I have given one side grid with given all the patterns. I have these stamp markers or these pens. And the other side, it is empty. What the child has to do is he has to copy this pattern here. So it's going to be again a fun game. He needs to check which grid, which box has which pattern, and then stamp it in each of the boxes. This one again is our idea. Directions. Circle the arrows to its color. So I have given 4 directions: right, up, left and downwards, and all randomly written the arrow marks here. The child has to choose this color sketch pen, and wherever it is right direction, he is going to circle it. Like that, for 4 directions he is going to complete it. And this one is the matrix activity. There is y-axis and x-axis here, x and y-axis, and I have given some circle under each box. What the child has to find is, see here it is A and 6. So he will have to search for A and 6 and then put it, circle it here. Like this, he is going to complete this one. I haven't done this type of activity with Rithvik, so I thought it's a good start to do it with him. So here you can see. And this is another activity that I have copied from Sonali again. So they have given 3 patterns here. And under each box I have drawn it, and but haven't completed it. The child is going to fill the rest of the pattern. Whatever I have left it from here, the child has to complete it. And the last box I have left empty. So here the child has to draw the complete pattern. So that's one activity. And this is a tally chart. So for Rithvik, I've been thinking to introduce division and basic graph to him. So this is again the graph idea. So I found it very well interested. That's why I have picked this idea as well. And here you can see the grid here. I have just drawn the pictures, and then in this box I have drawn the pictures and given the space for him to look at the number and fill in the number here. And on this grid, this is the graphing. And suppose apple, he has to count apple 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, write number 5. And under apple here, he'll have to shade it till 5. So this is Sonali's idea. I hope you don't mind, Sonali. A few ideas I have taken from you. This one, I have done it. This is objective of this game is to block the opponent. So I have some manipulators. I have taken these. This is our childhood game. Most of us would have definitely played this one with friends and family. So we place it like this. So suppose he takes green color and I take red color, and we'll have to by moving this coin, we have to finally block the opponent so that he cannot move any other side. So this is one game, and it's upside down. And the final activity for today, this is again a good brain boosting activity. It's most of you again would have played this one, but for a child, I'm introducing this all for the first time. Here, he has to say the color of each word and he shouldn't read the word. It is easy to say what is written here, black, white, yellow. That's easy to say, but the game is he has to read the color, that is, read the word, that is, what is it? This is black, white. I was myself getting confused. Like I said, he has to say the color of each word. What is the color of this word? This is red. He cannot say black because that is written, but he has to identify what is the word. Red, black, green, and blue, like that. He goes on saying this one. So we're going to play these things for now. Hope you guys liked it. Any suggestions, please let me know. Thank you.